Okay, so this morning, Brady sent me an email and he said, check this out, something has happened. So on Sunday, it was the Super Bowl. I didn't know that myself. I think, Brady, did you know it was the Super Bowl this weekend?
Yes, I stayed up and watched it. I love the Super Bowl.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. Apparently, we have two conferences. We've got the NFC, National Football Conference. We've got the AFC, the American Football Conference. And so every year, they have a team from each conference and they play the Super Bowl. Okay, so for the last 14 years, the previous 14 years, the team that represents the NFC have won the coin toss. Well, it's certainly a really unlikely event. Now, unlikely events happen. So last Sunday, this winning streak of 14 wins that they had so far was broken. So last Sunday, it was the AFC, the team that represented the AFC. Was it the Patriots? The Patriots won the coin toss. So that's breaking our streak of 14 successive wins.
They then did lose the game though.
Oh, that's a shame, isn't it? Never mind. Okay, yeah, enough of this football stuff. Right, let's do some maths. Right, so we're going to work out how long it would take to get that streak of 14 in a row, 14 wins in a row, right? So to make this a bit easier, we're not just going to dive into the full thing. We're not going to work out 14 wins in a row. I'll make this a bit easier. We're going to look at getting 3 wins in a row. If we can work this out, if we can understand it, the rest is easy. Let's work out how long it would take to get 3 wins in a row. Okay, so this is the odds of winning the coin toss. Not the game, no. I could see Brady doing this. I thought he was giving me the thumbs up. He was like, yeah, good. Right, what I want to look at first is, let's look at getting 3 wins or winning 3 coin tosses in a row. Okay, so first of all, what's the probability of getting those 3 wins? Now, this is quite easy. I think a lot of people can do this themselves. So we're looking for 3 wins in a row. A probability of winning the coin toss is 1/2. So to win 1 time is 1/2. To win again, you times it by 1/2 again. And then to win 3 times, you times by 1/2. Okay, so 1/8 of the time, you could win 3 coin tosses. What about a streak of 4, a sequence of 4? Because that means you've lost, and then you won. 1. So it's loss, win, win, win. Now, what's the probability of that? Again, not too hard to work out. 1/2, 1/2, 1/2, 1/2, 1/16. 1/16th of the time, you're going to get a sequence of 4 games that ends with win, 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 or 4 coin tosses. So what we're going to work out is the average sequence, the length of the average sequence that ends with win, win, win. What if it was a sequence that was 5? That means it could be like loss, loss, then ends with win, win, win. Or you could have a win, then a loss, win, win, win. For each of those, the probability is 1/32, but there's 2 of them. So altogether, if your sequence is 5 games long, it's 2/32. So if you want to work out the probability of the average sequence length, what you do is you take the sequence lengths, each situation, and multiply them by the probability of getting that situation. Now, this is our waiting time. This is how long we want to wait for our win, win, win. Now, that it looks like you would have to work out every single possible situation, every possible probability for that situation, multiply them all together. That would give you your average. So that would include all possible situations like win, win, loss, loss, win, win, win. Then it would be win, loss, win, loss, win, loss, win, win, win. So every single possible situation. And that does not sound like fun. So there's a really clever way to do this. And this is really clever. Right, I'll show you how to do this. I'm going to draw you a little picture for this. So let's say you lose here and then win. Or lose and win. Or lose here and win. Okay, I've drawn you a little picture. So probability of losing is 1/2, losing your coin toss. Probability of winning the coin toss is 1/2. Let's say we're looking for the time we have to wait to get these 3 wins in a row. Let's call that T. Now, in the first case, I can toss my coin, and if I lose, I'm back to square one. I've tossed a coin, and then I'm back, I have to do it all over again. So the length of that sequence, I've tossed a coin, then I'm back to square one. Back to square one means I'm back to this. I'm back to waiting T games for my sequence of three. T. That's how long I would have to wait if I lose. And the probability of losing is a half. Times it by the probability, that's what you get. The other situation is this. You could win, then lose, and back to square one. Win and lose, probability is a quarter. And then you're back to square one, where you've tossed it once, you've tossed the coin twice, and then you're back to square one. That means you have to wait T again. That's how many games you have to wait. Or the third situation is, you win, and then you lose. Oh, and you're back to square one. So what's the probability of that happening? That's an eighth. Then, ooh, three coin tosses, back to square one means three plus T. Or, and the final situation is, you get it straight away. Win, win, win. And the probability of that is 1/8. And how long did I have to wait? Three coin tosses, win, win, win. And you've got your three wins in a row. Fantastic. You solve this. This is what you do. You solve this formula. It's not that hard to solve. You just multiply that out, mess around with it. I can tell you, if you do solve it, the answer is T equals 14. This is the average length that you would have to wait, the average number of games you would have to wait to get three wins in a row. Now, if you want to do it in general, if you want to do it for 14, pretty much the same idea. The same idea, but in general, you get this. T is equal to 2 to the power n plus 1 minus 2. That is the amount of time you would have to wait to get n wins in a row. N wins. N is going to be 14 for the Super Bowl. In the Super Bowl, it was 14. So if n equals 14, we're going to use this. And I can tell you the answer. It was 32,766. We would have to play 32,766 games before, well, that's the average anyway, before you could expect to get 14 wins in a row. That's the average. I mean, maybe it will take longer. Maybe you'll get it straight away. We don't know. But on average, it's going to be about 32,000 games, maybe 32,000 years.
It only took 45 Super Bowls for them to get 14 coin tosses in a row, though.
Yeah, it did.
What happened?
So unlikely events can happen. Unlikely events like this can happen. Like I said before, we can toss as many coins as we want. It's not impossible, it's just unlikely. So this isn't a probability. What I've worked out isn't a probability. This isn't the probability of winning 14 times in a row. This is the length of time that we're going to wait, the number of games we're going to play, or the number of coin tosses we're going to do until we get 14 wins in a row. And it's the average number. And in the case of the Super Bowl, which happens only once a year, if you want this to happen again, then I would expect to wait 32,000 years, maybe 32,766 years even.